What's up everyone, welcome back to another Skyblog video. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do the Romeo and Juliet questline. Now the reason why you should be doing this questline is purely because you get a legendary talisman. And this grants a 1 in 100 chance to deal 100% damage, so it's definitely worth it. Now I do know where every single spot is, and I'll be showing you all of that, but you guys are going to need a lot of things. So if you don't have the item for this, then I'm very sorry, I guess you can't really complete it and you'll have to wait to do it. Anyways, let's get started with the first one. At first you'll be talking to Juliet, and then she'll tell you to go find him in a cave. But before you find him in the cave, what you need to go do first is actually get some gold. Now gold can be located in this little mine, and you will get a few shards from this, but I don't think I will get any since I've already done the quest. But anyways, once you mine the gold and it's your first time doing it, Romeo will be down here in the mine, so just go talk to him right here and he should be there and you should be able to complete your quest. After you talk to Juliet again, he will be located near the supermarket, and that is very easy to find. Simply go to the hub over here, and then Romeo will be right about here, and you're gonna need to give him some flowers. Now he's gonna need poppies, and I believe he needs a full stack of poppies, so once you give him that, you can move on into the third one. Now after you talk to him about the flowers, the next quest after that will be located in the graveyard. Now you'll get an emerald altar, and basically just go over here to your emerald altar. He'll be located about right here, and you'll need to give him about 64 emeralds to complete this. Now from here on out, it's gonna get a little bit pricey. The next area you'll need to go after doing the graveyard is located in the Blazing Fortress. Here in the Blazing Fortress, what you'll need to do is go up the stairs and basically just go up again and then take a left. Now you're just going to be going down the stairs until you reach this spot, and then Romeo will be right here. He's going to ask you for a stack of red mushrooms at first, and then he'll tell you to bring a red enchanted mushroom block. Now the reason why this is a little pricey is because if you go to the farming, go to mushroom, and then go to 8, I didn't have this unlocked myself, I had someone in my guild craft this for me. Basically, to get the red mushroom block enchanted, you need 9 stacks of red mushrooms, and that is kind of a lot. Mainly because you need to have a collection of 25,000 in order to craft this block. Anyways, that is still how you do that. Next, in the hub area, you're gonna have to find him in his castle. Now this is fairly easy to go to. I'm gonna take the fast route and basically just teleport all the way up here, but basically he'll be right here, and then he's gonna ask for some type of potion. Now you're gonna need a rabbit 6 potion, just a rabbit 6, but before you use water bottles, don't do that. If we make our way back down here and go all the way to the bartender, the bartender sells something called cheap coffee. You're gonna have to use some of these to make the potion. So before you make the rabbit 6 potion, be sure to use this because it won't work otherwise. Now, if I go to my manage auctions right now, I did sell a rabbit 6 potion for $1 million. That's how bad people really want to finish this quest. So, I mean, hey, if you have some extra resources lying around, might as well sell it because I'm sure some people will bid for it. Anyways, after you have brewed your potion, just right click him and then he'll go flying up into the moon and give you a nice moon piece. After you give him the rabbit potion, you're gonna have to make your way all the way to the gold mine. Now after you get to the gold mine, it's basically where the iron pickaxe is, where you want to get for the lazy miner. However, you want to take a left, and now towards the left you go down this steep hill and then he'll be located right here. Now this boy is expensive, okay? Now I already have the item, but you're gonna have to give him an enchanted lava bucket. Yes, he's greedy, he wants an enchanted lava bucket, so there you go. That's what you need in order to finish this quest. Now it seems that this next quest is one of the hardest ones to complete. Now the way to do this is by getting Wise Crystal Armor, and then you're going to want to have a Reaper Falcon for the extra intelligence. Anyways, next you want to make your way all the way over here near the fishing pond. Next you're going to want to go all the way up to this treehouse, and then you'll know what building it is because there are, well, you know, there's a bunch of people right here, and there is a emerald block just kind of indicating that it's here. Now if I go ahead and put my mana set on right now, I do get a good 1000 mana, however that is not enough. You need about 1200 to 1300 mana in order to do this. Now what you can do is go up this torch right here and you can get 1155 mana, but you need a Reaper Falcon in order to do this, at least that is the only way as of now. But this will give you 200 extra intelligence, and then basically all you want to do is right click him and then there you go, he is done. Another way you can do it too, I guess, is just by going around to the corner over here and then you'll have enough. I have like 1500 right now, and you can right click him this way. Anyways, yeah, that's how you do it. Get a full Wise Crystal Armor set, and then that is how you do it. For this next part, you're gonna want to have an emerald blade. Now, actually, if I go to my auction master right now and check, I am selling one right now and it sold for 862k, so I'm definitely making profit off this. However, the next area you'll want to go is all the way over to the Colosseum. After you're here, you want to take a sharp left and continue going straight until you get your next turn, which will be to your left. After that, he will be located right here, and then just right click him with your emerald blade, and that is what the item he needs. I'm sure everyone has emerald blade at this point, so yeah, just, you know, it's gonna take the item, but it's not a big deal. We're getting closer to finishing this. The next area you want to go to is all the way over to the Mushroom Desert. Now, I'm sure not a lot of you guys know where the smallest building is, but it's actually in the Mushroom Desert, so let me show you. After you get to the Mushroom Desert, just basically go over here, and then it will be right about here, past this little thing, and then he'll be right here. As you can see, it's a very small hut that he'll be located right there. Now, this item that he wants is a level 1 flower minion. Yes, a flower minion. Are you serious? Not even a level 2, not even level 3, nothing. It has to be a level 1 flower minion or else it will not work. But yeah, that's basically the only thing you need and then you're basically done. Now the next thing that you're going to do in order to get this to a legendary talisman is make your way over to the tailor over here and then go downstairs. Now here at Seymour, you can either buy a $3 million tuxedo, a $20 million tuxedo, or a $75 million tuxedo. Anyways, you don't need the $75 million one. You need the $3 million one in order to transform it into a legendary talisman. Now, fortunately for me, I had one of my guild members, Mind Tricks, sell it for me for 100k so I could use it, and I just gave it back to him. So that was very kind of him. That is basically what I did in order to get this because I didn't want to spend $3 million on the set. Now, the last thing you must do is go all the way over here and talk to Juliet, and then you are basically done, and they will live happily ever after. Like, as you can see, I am done with it, and they are just betraying their hearts right now. It's great. So once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video. That is how you complete this quest line. It is very, very expensive towards the end, but it is very easy for a free talisman if you're just starting off. You don't really need much for the first few, but overall, guarantee you, this is definitely worth it. If you guys did like this video, be sure to drop a like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in another video. Peace out.